They're the last remaining Filipino farming community in the United States. Some are the descendants of the manongs, Filipino men who were hired straight from the Philippines in the early 1900s to work in the farms of California and Hawaii. And like those who came before them, these Central Valley farmers used traditional farming methods, planting fruits and vegetables that are considered Filipino flavors. Based in Orosi, California, these farmers created the group Filipino Community Supported Agriculture to introduce their work and produce to larger cities.
We are the last traditional Filipino farming community now. And so we feel that the CSA is the best avenue to reach out.
Del Vioso's father was a cicada, hired to work in Hawaii's fields. She and her brother Danny were born into the farming world.
It's in the blood where you can't even think about it working for anybody else anymore. I haven't quit farming.
Like the Galbiosos, most of the Filipino CSA members have roots from Ilocos, like Jean Kumkem, who has spent the past 20 years in Orosi.
Masaya naman. Maraming gulay, maraming kumpas.
Filipino CSA recently launched their very own farmers market at the Filipino Workers Center, offering vegetables found in Filipino dishes like suluyot, ampalaya, sitaw, kangkong, and kamote.
To support them in many ways we can as part of a community.
PWC was inspired to bring them to LA as they were exploring the Delano farmlands, where Larry Itliong, a Filipino union leader, led agricultural workers in fighting for better wages and benefits in the Delano grape strike of 1965. These modern-day Filipino farm workers are set to hold their next market this weekend to mark Itliong's birthday. As these Filipino farmers branch out beyond the Central Valley, they're hoping to plant seeds of positive change within their community. With competition from large food companies, they're hoping communities will continue to buy local and support farmers like them.
Not only selling our vegetables, I mean, we're going into winter, but selling our prepared goods, some of our finished products, until we start planting in February.
As they look to partner with more community organizations, they're also seeking to raise funds to upgrade their farming methods. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.